Seven Lakes here, first game in district. Talk about the defense. Y'all held them to 74 points in the first half.
Well, you know, they came out pretty strong in the beginning. We just made some adjustments real quick with the timeout. We shut them down the rest of the game. Had a chance to put our backups in, you know, get everyone some playing time. Let's get a homecoming. It's a good game.
Cool. Did it feel good for you being after that Westbrook win to come out here and come home in front of the hometown crowd?
Yes, sir. It felt good. You know, Westbrook was a good team. We knew Seven Lakes would put up a fight. We just had to come out and shut them up for the homecoming, you know, just for the fans. It's all for the fans.
Hey, congratulations. Talk about, you know, going playing straight Jesuit next week. Are you ready for their offense?
Yes, sir. I mean, we're coming in tomorrow. Just going back to work. They put up a good fight against Woodlands, apparently. So, I mean, just don't want to go in and underestimate them. It's going to be a big game.
Because, I don't know, it's interception, you know, it's a fun thing to get. So, you know, outside backer Drew was underneath it, so I played over the top, and it went right over him, so I kind of tipped it to myself. It surprised me for a second, but then I grabbed it, and all my teammates blocked for me, so I was able to get into the end zone.
Were you feeling that end zone?
Oh, yeah, I wanted it so bad, you know. I wanted to score. Matt Diamond has always been missing play with a touchdown so far, so I wanted to join him in the touchdown club. So.
That's awesome.
You know how many times you batted against Martins in baseball?
Oh, I have no idea, but it was quite a few.
Did he struck you out a couple times, huh?
Yeah, he probably got me.
Yeah, that's payback.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Talk about how active you guys are in that secondary. You know, against a passing team, it seems like you really confused the quarterback, made him throw a lot of bad balls, and you guys took advantage of them.
Yeah, you know, I think this year our secondary is real strong, but really we have Nick coming back, you know, big year for him, surviving cancer, and he's got that pass, he still has the pass rush that he's always had, so that just rushes on even more. John Sampa in the middle takes up three people, just frees up our DN, so, you know, it helps tremendously with the D-line that makes them rush the throw, and then we're in position to make the play.
Hey,
yeah,
so, what do you think about Strikes? Have you seen anything from them? I just
remember last year when we scrimmaged them. Kind of remember their offense a little bit. We're going to watch video a little bit tomorrow over them and start Monday with scouting report. So, I'm looking forward to it, though.
That'll be a good game.
That's right. For sure. Right,
cool. Seven Lakes is going to come out and play hard and stuff. And, you know, first couple plays we've had offensively kind of, you know, had us on the field a little bit. And just getting the kids refocused and stuff. And, you know, they did a good job, you know, and our kid did a good job moving the football. And I really felt like we had the game under control, you know, early on. It's just, you know, you never want to take things for granted and stuff. And, you know, I got a lot of respect for their staff and stuff they've done over there. You know, good win for our kids. We've got to play a lot of kids in the game.
But defensively, you set the tone in the first half, holding them to 74 yards.
Yeah, that's like I said, we played against a great football team. They're very, very good offenses and stuff. And the real physical offensive line. You know, their offensive line, they were more of a finesse passing the ball team. They threw up 20-something times in the first half. You know, it was good for our kids to sit there and play against that. We'll see that stuff later on. You know, our kids made some plays in the first half, and that was good to see. And, you know, we had some injuries and stuff, and the other kids stepped up and played. You know, that's what being a team is about when somebody goes down, somebody else has to step up and play.
How do you feel about the passing game today?
Well, we made some real fine plays and passing game-wise, but that's what I've been waiting on. And I don't think our timing was still as good as I had hoped it was going to be, but, you know, it's coming around, and, you know, that's been the story of us as far as throwing the football. It's going to come around, and we've got, you know, a good quarterback, and he's got to make good decisions and things. But, you know, like I said, it's going to come around and be better than what it was.
Donovan had over 200 yards and Adam over 100. So.
That's what you'd expect from those kids. Like I said, they didn't have as good a personnel as what we played against. We've been able to run football against some really good football teams. So I expected them to sit there and have big nights and stuff. And, like I said, the turnovers worried me. And in the end, you know, the object was to win the game.
How do you feel about, I know you haven't looked at Straight Jesuit, but obviously they're one of those dangerous teams. I mean, look what they did to the Woodlands. They almost stole one from them.
Yeah, we've seen them. We're going to see them again tomorrow night. And like I said, I understand Coach Counter and his staff do a great job of coaching. They do a great job of picking at you and stuff and frustrating you. And that's what you're going to have to do. You can't get frustrated. You're going to have to sit there and be effective running the football and be able to throw it when we want, not when we have to. Like I said, I've got a lot of respect for them. They're the next step, you know. And we better respect everyone, that's what, you know, how you sit there and have a chance to sit there and play for a championship. You better not overlook anybody, because they can definitely beat you. They proved that against the Woodlands, and like I said, the district race is far from over. And like I said, it's the next step. I know we still got, you know, six district games to go, so we've got a long ways to go in this thing.